Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain about resolution modifiers. In my last video, I have explained about dependency injection in depth. As part of that, I have also explained about hierarchical dependency injection. If you have seen that video, you will be able to understand resolution modifiers easily. You can find the link to that video in the description. Okay, let me explain the injection hierarchy in short. Whenever a dependency is used in a component, Angular will first check if the component defines a dependency injector in its decorator. That means whether the dependency is provided in that component. If it is not, then Angular will check in the immediate parent component. And that goes till the root module. In case, even in root module, if you have not provided that dependency, then Angular will throw null injector error or no provider found error. This is how Angular resolves the injector token. But in Angular, we have also some resolution modifiers. Those can be used to modify the default Angular resolution behavior. Those are at optional, at self skip, and at host. Let me use an example to explain each one of them. In this application, I have a parent component in which I have used a child component. And in child component, I have a button. On clicking this button, I am calling a function. Inside this function, I am calling a function from a logger service. You can also see that I have used a dependency provider use class. I am going to explain about dependency providers in my next video. For now, just want to highlight that using use class, we can use our own implementation of the logger service. And so you can see, I have also created two more services and used the respective service in each component. Therefore, if I run the application, we can see child logger is constructed, and on clicking this button, we can see this child button is clicked message. And if I comment this provider in child, as I mentioned before, as per hierarchy injection, it will look into the parent component for provider. And as we have provider in parent, we can see parent logger is constructed, and on clicking this button, we can see this message. This is the default behavior. We can change this. First, let me use @self. When we use @self, we are insisting to find the injectors only in the same component. And so, if it is provided in the same component, it will work. Otherwise, it will throw no providers found error. It won't look into the parent or root injectors. Next one is @skipself. This is just the opposite of @self. When we add this one, even though we provide in the same component, it skips that and always look into the parent. Okay, before going into @host, let me explain about @optional. Let me remove all the providers, and so it will throw no providers found error. Now we can prevent this error by adding @optional decorator. So the error will not throw. But this functionality will not work because Angular will set the value for our service to null. Okay, to explain the @host, I have created two directives. One I have named as parent and the other one as child. In the child component, I have added these directives like this. And I have also created two logger service and provided that in each directive using use class. Now as we have provided the service in our child directive, we could see this message. Let me remove this provider. Now it will look in the parent directive. Here also we have provided, and so now we can see this message. Let me remove the provider from here also. Now we can see it is provided from the child component. If we remove here, it will go up to the root module. Now let me introduce @host decorator in the child directive and let me provide them in all places like before. Let's see now. We are able to see this message. Let me remove the provider here. Now we can see it is getting provider from the parent directive. Let me remove from here also. Now we can see it is throwing no providers error because @host will look into their host element only. It won't go further up. Hope you understood. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.